All right, guys. So we're going to go through Sia's album, A Thousand Forms of Fear. All right. Now, quite a few songs I've already done reactions to, so we're going to skip those. And we're going to do the rest of the songs that I haven't actually heard yet. So let's go ahead and check out the rest of this album. All right. So the first one we got is Burn the Pages. Okay.
Your dark gray like a storm cloud, swelling up with rage that is desperate to be let out. And I know it's a heavy load, carrying those fears around, carrying those fears around. Worry makes the world go round. Twisted up like a slim knot.
All right, so on second thought, I'm just gonna pull up lyric videos for most of these, all right? Because so far, I have no idea what she's singing about. You know what I'm saying? Let's go ahead and try this again, y'all. I'm loving this.
Your dark gray like a storm cloud, swelling up with rage that is desperate to be let out.
So I think what she's talking about here is someone who's very sad and who is like on the verge of being in tears. I think that's what she's talking about.
And I know it's a heavy load, carrying those fears around, carrying those fears around. Worry makes the world go round. Twisted up like a slim knot, tied by a goose that just took his t-shirt.
All right, guys, let's try this again. All right, the last video, the lyrics wasn't quite right. All right, so I found a different one. I think this one might be more accurate. You're dark gray, like a storm cloud, swelling up with rage that is desperate to be let out. So now I'm having a much different interpretation. Last time I thought it was someone who was on the verge of tears, which still could be, because there's sometimes you would get like so freaking mad that you would actually start crying, right? It's possible. Okay. Okay, I'm definitely understanding what she's singing about now. All right. So what she's trying to say with the song, you know, try and leave the past where it belongs. All right. You know, you've had some struggles. You've had a lot of things go wrong. Try and move past it and look toward the future. All right. So that's what I'm getting out of this so far.
Blues roll, risen from the undertow, all is well. We welcome the cry of the dark night sky. Swallow me peacefully, follow my heart back inside. So don't worry, I'm here by your side. By your...
Oh, I see. So I'm checking out the lyrics from Genius. All right. So the phrase you said that she says in here, apparently, that refers to someone who's a heavy drinker. All right. So she is probably talking about someone who's been abused. So then the line, I know there's a hungry dog tugging at your frayed ends, but he's just playing with you. He wants to be your friend. So I think what this is talking about is how someone would be, going through a breakup and they're really emotional, and then, you have guys come around and start trying to like comfort them and want to be friendly towards them, and then they start thinking like, this person is just wanting, that kind of stuff, right? Like, they're not actually caring about me at all. But what she's saying here is that it's not like that every single time, because sometimes it may think you may feel that way, but it could be that they genuinely just want to be your friend. All right. Eyes stinging from the black smoke, new hope, lose hope, risen from the undertow, all is well. We welcome the cry of the dark night sky. Swallow me peacefully, follow my heart back inside. Yeah, I'm kind of at a loss for this last verse right here. Let's see what the analytics say on this one. Have you ever been exposed to smoke? And that's kind of the way I was thinking, right? Make it burn and eventually turn red, relating to the chorus. The smoke came from the burning books. Oh, okay, I wasn't even thinking about the burning books. In which the character could not look away from because of the shock they received from letting their pains go. In a turn of events, he or she finds hope after all the ropes of life seem to be loosening. Okay, guys, so I think I'm starting to understand verse 3. All right. So verse 3 circles back to verse 1, where she's talking about, the raging storms and all of that. All right. So it says, eyes stinging from the black smoke, new hope, loose hope. In other words, hope is up for grabs because you are trying to leave your past in the past. You're trying to move forward. So there's new hope there for you to be able to hold on to. All right. So then it says, loose hope, risen from the undertow, all is well. So I think what she's talking about is during a storm. The undertow would get a lot stronger because of the currents, right? So the currents are going to pick up, the currents are going to be stronger. So during the process of a raging storm, there's also going to be hope that's going to come out of that, risen from the undertow. We welcome the cry of the dark night sky. Swallow me peacefully, follow my heart back inside. So back inside the storm clouds, is what I'm getting from this. The storm clouds. So y'all let me know what y'all think about that. Am I close, or have I not getting the concept of it? All right. Now, of course, the concept on the surface is very easy to understand. You know, she's talking about trying to move forward and get over, traumatic experiences, breakups, abusive relationships, whatever that is. But there's a lot of, under the surface things that I wanted to do an analysis on. You know what I'm saying? So I think what we're going to do, I think we're going to, do the rest of these songs all in one video, but the songs are going to be shortened. All right. Like the repeating choruses, like those could be trimmed out, like quite a bit of the music could be trimmed out. Reason being, I know if I try to play like 90% of a whole album, like that's probably going to get blocked. And it probably would be, really difficult to get the whole thing up. All right. So I think that's what we're gonna do. So y'all just better strap in, because this is gonna be a long one. Okay. So this is quite a bit different than what I was expecting coming from this album specifically. All right, Thousand Forms of Fear. So this song definitely isn't within that theme. All right, this one's basically just a love song. So yeah, let's keep going. This prison is rough and I can't get enough. The secret about us keeps being a ghost. So the secret's safe. So no one else knows what type of relationship they have, that it's very, well, I'm sure you guys can get the picture. You know what I'm saying? I shouldn't need to spell that out. All right. Those who have heard those under the covers. Okay. There was one part in there about why do you keep breaking my heart or something like that. All right. So what I think here is this is not really a healthy relationship. You shouldn't really feel like a hostage to someone's love, right? So she feels like if she doesn't get that love and attention, then like everything's wrong in the world, like nothing can be okay. That's a level of dependency that you really don't want to have. Like, that's not a healthy relationship. All right. So I think this is kind of fitting with the overall theme of the album. All right. So that's really interesting. I thought at first it was just a love song, but not really. It looks that way on the surface. And I think that also explains the line in there about our, you know, secret being a ghost. No one knows our secret. That, you know, actually, we're not very happy together. Like, this is not a good relationship. All right. It just looks that way on the surface. I think that's what's going on here. Really sad thing. You know what I'm saying? Really, really sad. Fair Game is up next.
You terrify me, 'cause you're a man, you're not a boy. You got some power, and I can't treat you like a toy. You're the wrong
right.
Flesh, traveled by a little girl. You disregard the mess while I try to control the world. Don't leave me, stay here and frighten me. Don't leave me, come now, enlighten me. Give me all you got, give me your wallet and your watch. Give me your firstborn, give me the rainbow and the... So go and challenge me, take the reins and see. Watch me squirm, baby, but you are just what I need. And I'll never play.
So this one seems to kind of elaborate on the last song we heard. You know what I'm saying? Really interesting concept for an album we got right here. All right. And Chandelier is on this album as well. And I don't know if many of you guys understand the meaning of that song. It's about alcoholism. If you actually pay attention to the lyrics and what she's talking about in there, it's about overcoming addiction, but specifically alcohol. All right.
A fair game, I've always had the upper hand. But what good is intellect and play? I can't respect any man. Yeah, I want to play a fair game. Yeah, I want to play a fair game.
Absolutely. Yeah, I just did a video from Dax, what it's like to be a man, and I was talking about a lot of these things in there. All right. If you want respect, you got to give respect. If you don't give respect, then how can you expect to get respect in return? All right. It's just like if you walk up to someone and hit them, there's a good chance they're going to hit you back. All right. They're not going to ask questions. They're not going to be respectful at that point. Because you didn't give them any respect. All right. You know, instead of giving them a warning, instead of saying, you know, look, if you keep doing that, things are going to get ugly. You have to at least give someone a warning, like, you know, if they're doing something wrong, that's getting ready to set you off. Like, you need to let them know that. You know, let them know, like, you need to get away from me right now because this isn't going good. You know what I'm saying? Things are going to get bad. So you need to back off. But if you can't even do that, you just walk up to someone and hit them, they're not going to be respectful towards you after that. You know what I'm saying? So she wants to play a fair game. She wants mutual respect, and that's what's important here. All right.
You terrify me. We've still not kissed, and yeah, I've cried. You got too close, and I pushed and pushed open your bites so I could run, run. And that I did, but through the dust, you saw those teeth marks. They weren't all yours. You had been thrust into a history.
Oh, man.
You worked for me into a history. Which I could not.
You saw all the teeth marks, not all those were yours. So all the scars that she has, us a lot of it from other people that have emotionally damaged her as well. So she's still like, when you are putting her through turmoil, right? She's also remembering back to other people that have done some of the similar stuff. You know, she's also thinking about similar things other people's done to her as well. All right. And that's what she's trying to relay this message here. Like, you're just compiling onto a lot of other issues, a lot of other people have done, and now you're making it worse. You need to understand that.
I'm free, so go on, shake me. Shake until I give it up. Wear me down, baby. I know that we could make some love. So go on and challenge me. Take the reins and see. Watch me squirm, baby. But you are just what I need. And I have never played a fair game. I've always had the upper hand. But what good is intellect and their play if I can't respect any man? I want to play
I think she's realizing right now, like, wait a minute, I've not been playing fair. Yeah, I've always had the upper hand. And, you know, if you always win by default, you know, that starts to tell you something. All right. That's starting to give you a clue that, hey, wait a minute, something's not right here. Was an amazing song. You know what I'm saying? Absolutely loved it. All right. Free the Animal is what we got now, y'all. Oh man. She's starting out rough with this one. Our love is so wanna throw you from the roof. Man, she's going in. That's a bad relationship right there. You really shouldn't, you know, feel that way about someone you actually really love and care about. The pressure builds when I put my hands through you. I'll squeeze you tight until you take your last breath, loving you to death. That is terrible. Bye. You know, I almost think Free the Animal is about wanting them to be honest about their feelings. Like, even if you want to throw me from the roof, you want to do all these horrible things to me, like, you need to be honest about that and tell me what the deal is. You know what I'm saying? Because I need to know right now if I need to start packing my stuff and hightail it out of here. You know what I'm saying? Honesty is important. Communication is crucial. All right, got to be able to talk. Now, here's what I am going to say. Crimes of passion are very common when it comes to that type of crime. All right? So bear that in mind. She's going way too fast on this part, y'all. Murder me, ruin me. Look what you do to me. Beautiful pain, baby. That's another song that she was a part of. Amazing song right there, y'all. Pour acid rain on me. Kill me with your loving. I'll slice you and dice you. Like sugar and spice. Ah, sugar and spice. So this is a love-hate relationship. There's love there, but there's also hate. So it's sugar and spice, right? It's like honey and vinegar. You know what I'm saying? So, it's like I said, communication is key. Also, understanding patterns. If things are getting hectic and chaotic, and they keep getting more and more hectic and chaotic, that's your red flags. That's the warning signs that's telling you things could end up getting really, really bad. Don't let it get to that point. You know what I'm saying? Just don't. Your loving, kill me with your loving. I slice you and dice you like sugar and spice. I'll do all that you want me to be on the beast, and you kill you with my loving. I kill you with my loving. Murder me, ruin me, look what you do to me. Beautiful pain, baby, pour acid rain on me. Kill me with your loving, kill me with your loving. I slice you and dice you like sugar and spice. I'll do all that you want me to be on the beast, and you kill you with my loving. I kill you with my loving. Oh man, y'all. I just absolutely love her songs. Like, they're all thought-provoking. They're emotional. They have important messages behind them. Say, I absolutely love her music, y'all. So we got two more songs, y'all. This one's called Cell Phone. Very haunting.
Look at me, I'm such a basket case. Delivered to you wrapped in cellophane.
Oh,
Sitting
cellophane.
on your doorstep.
Look, I have dyslexia. Okay. You know what I'm saying? I thought it was cell phone. It's not cell phone, it's cellophane. All right. Waiting on your doorstep every day. Delivery. A basket filled with pain. Why? What is going on with this song, y'all?
Me, I'm such a basket case.
Let's start this over again.
Look at me, I'm such a basket case. Delivered to you wrapped in cellophane. Waiting on your doorstep every day. Delivery, a basket filled with pain. Patience is your virtue, saint of mine. I'd have fallen through the cracks without your love tonight. I'm your groundhog and I'm skating on thin ice. But you see me at your feet and carry me inside.
I'm not sure about that last line, but what I was getting ready to say was this was making me think of fried green tomatoes. You know what I'm saying? The way she was wrapped in cellophane and when she opened the door, you know what I'm saying? Come on now. It might be what she's talking about, but then this last line right here. Watch the blood pump through my veins. I don't understand what she's getting at yet. Let's just keep going.
Look at me, I'm such a basket case. While I fall apart, you'll hide all my pills again. And all the things I need to hear you say. Your watch as all my thoughts get right back on the drain.
This is what I love about Sia. All right. She leaves like the beginning of her song such a mystery, and you're watching the lyrics, right? Paying attention to it, and you're going, I have no idea what the song's really about. And then she starts leaving like subtle clues. And then usually around the end of the song is where it's going to click, and then that's when like she's going to break the case wide open, right? And then if you've paid attention to all the clues throughout the song, then you'll get it and everything will make sense. That's what I love about her music. All right. So I did catch in there. She was talking about hiding pills. I think this is about drug addiction. The deliveries could be medications wrapped in cellophane. So it could be a drug dealer who takes the pills and wraps them in cellophane, right? That could be what's going on here. This could also be about needles specifically. You know what I'm saying? Watching the blood pump through your veins. I'm thinking that could be a reference to taking drugs through a needle, that kind of thing. I think the drugs feels like electricity when it hits her brain. I think that's what's going on here. Very serious topic we're talking about in this video. All right. Now, if you guys understand the lyrics any better than I did, put in the comments and let me know. Yes, that was a good lyric video right here. All right. And this is coming from Lyrics for Days. Now, I'm gonna have a link to all of the lyric videos I played, all right? So that way I am showing support for the people who took the time to create these lyric videos, all right? Last video of the album. Oh, I forgot about one. There's one other song we gotta do, and that's the Eye of the Needle. All right, I haven't done a reaction to that one yet, and I've seen it. I know the song fairly well, so I'm not going to do a lyric video. We're going to do a live video for that one. Dressed in black.
Kept me from heaven and hell. Oh, yeah, I had a love was all I let myself know. Yeah, I had locked my heart. I was imprisoned by God. I thought.
Oh man, y'all. I just love her music. All right. Like I said, it's so impactful and thought-provoking. All right. Just amazing, y'all. I love her voice, y'all. So, what she's saying is she had basically given up on everything. She was just a walking shell of the person she used to be. This kind of makes me think of the song Man in Black from Johnny Cash, to where he would carry the darkness of the world on his back. So that's kind of the vitality I'm getting from this, right? Really interesting concept here, that even if you're in this position, you're dressed in black, you have a really somber kind of mentality, a view on the world, right, is very depressing and bleak. You know what I'm saying? Someone could still come along and see potential in you and understand that you're going through a hard time and your personality probably isn't, the way that it's perceived at that moment. You know what I'm saying? Really great message here. And what I would like to take out of this and to relay back to you guys, just because you see someone having a bad day and being rude to someone, or they're just not acting the way you think they should, and you want to go off on them and do whatever, you got to at least take into consideration that some really bad stuff might have just happened to that person. And it might not mean that they're a horrible, evil person. It could mean that life has just caught up to them and they broke and they snapped. You know what I'm saying? So try to bear that in mind. You set me free like a butterfly kissing a child with an eye for the minor key. I'm not sure what she means by that in this line right here, y'all. This was an amazing song. You know what I'm saying? Absolutely loved it. Absolutely amazing. All right. Now the outro of the song ran on for quite a while. You know what I'm saying? You know, and I'm just realizing how long this song is. It's almost 7 minutes. All right. You guys ain't going to have a 7 minute video out of this. It's going to be shortened down quite a bit. All right. Got to, because of copyright. If you want to hear the whole thing, you can follow the link and go listen to the whole thing. You know what I'm saying? So now we're going to actually see Maddie Ziegler. All right. Absolutely love seeing her. She is a phenomenal dancer. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to be pulling up the lyrics on this because I never have paid attention to the lyrics or, you know, anything like that. But I've heard the song a bunch of times. It is phenomenal. You know what I'm saying? Oh man, y'all, you know, I think this is a perfect song to end a video on. You know, this song is just so beautiful and amazing. All right. And, you know, I'm starting to recall some of the lyrics that's in here. This is a fantastic song. I admit you're gone, and I you're locked inside my heart at your melodies and art. I won't let the terror in. I'm stealing time through the eye of a needle. And the pre-chorus, she's saying, and I ain't ready, but I'll hold steady. I'll hold you in my arms. In my arms. I think maybe she's not ready to accept this person fully, but she wants to. All right, I'm not ready, but I'll hold steady. I will be there waiting just in case, you know, things line up and I start to be able to trust you. You know what I'm saying? I think that is what the song is about so far. In verse 1, she says, take me down, I'm feeling now. And if I move on, I admit you're gone. So this is, I think, her directing this towards someone else that she's lost. So, in order for me to move on, I have to admit that you're gone. So, she still has a lot of attachment to this other person. All right. Smile through the pain, feel the acid rain. Oh man, this is ringing so true. I think a lot of people could really identify with this, right? This is just an amazing song right here, y'all. I think I'm starting to understand this line. I'm stealing time through the eye of a needle. So she's holding on to hope that there might be a possible relationship here. And so she's stealing that time, right? That she's not for sure she can give that person that time, right? So she may not have the time to give that person, but she's stealing the time just in case. You know what I'm saying? The only thing is, the time that she's stealing is very, very small because it's through the eye of a needle. It's not like a water hose where she could get a lot of time out of it, right? This is through the eye of a needle, so. She's very sketchy. She's very, she has a lot of baggage, which she's going to talk about here in a second. Because I just heard that. My bags heavy, been filled by me. They weigh me down. Carry them around. It's all mine, all mine. I'm blinded by the eye of the needle. So that last line right there, I'm not too sure what she means, so I'm going to click on the annotation on it real quick. I'm blinded by the eye of the needle. Usually, the point of the needle is what hurts people. When the eye's nearby, it's not what pierces skin or gouges eyes. With physical pain equals point. At the same time, she plays with words, relating a human eye to the eye of a needle. The emotional pain is what's ruining her mind, making her mentally blind. Losing a love is hard. The eye of the needle represents the small glimmer of hope that she clings to. In this line, Sia finally realizing that by hanging on to that small amount of hope for the relationship to work, she's become blind to everything around her. Her friends, her family, the passage of time, and life, etc. So what I'm getting from that is when you're trying to thread a needle, right? You can't really see anything else. Like, you're only focused on that small, small hole. You know what I'm saying? And it gets really frustrating. Especially if you don't have the tool that makes it easier to thread needles. Alright? So, that is really interesting. I'm blinded by the eye of the needle. So, in other words, it's the thing where, you know, you can't see the forest for the trees, right? You know, you are focused on one thing, and then you lose your spatial awareness for everything else that's going on around you. You know what I'm saying? While she's focused on this relationship that may or may not work, there could be other better relationships that she could have instead, all right? I think that's what's going on here. So she's saying in there, I won't let the terror in. I'm stealing time through the eye of a needle. Alright, that's what she's saying, specifically. Alright. But she's feeling the terror. You know what I'm saying? She's stealing time just to try to hold on longer. Right? Oh man, y'all. Just look at the emotion on her face. The, you know, everything about this performance was, you know, so well done. All right. You know, she's not just here dancing, going through the motions, right? She's putting effort into it. She's expressing emotion through the song. All right. You know, such a great performer right here. All right. You know, the song was amazing. You know, and this goes to show why she loves having Maddie Ziegler, you know, be in a lot of her videos. Because she's phenomenal. She is a phenomenal dancer. You know what I'm saying? All right, that's it for now, y'all.